So, hello, my name is Lior and I'm a leader at Bluevine. Our story starts a couple of years ago when I worked at a small startup. We were successful, and with success comes growth. With growth comes security. We needed for a couple of partners to be SOC 2 compliant. And we needed to think about new rules for the company. One of them was everybody that leaves their station immediately have to lock their computer. It means that even if you for 5 minutes go to grab a coffee or help somebody, you have to remember and lock your computer. 5 minutes timeout doesn't count. The issue with this is two things. The security team starts to be more aggressive. Internal vulnerabilities instead of external ones. Working on the company instead of working attacks against the company. And the second thing, company workers, your friends, start to behave differently. Pranking one another, hacking one another's computer, deciding that they are the judge, jury, and execution for security issues. By the way, raise your hand. How many people hacked other friend computer? I see. In my opinion, personally, it's a bad company dynamics. What to do? What to do in this case? You can hack back and be part of the problem. You can get annoyed, mad, and scream about everybody. Or you can think about better way. I have an idea. I have a phone. Phone is a Bluetooth device. I can use my Bluetooth device to detect distance and automatically lock and unlock my computer. What is the first thing that we are doing when we think about an idea like this and want to develop it? Exactly, Google it. Kaddish. Okay, so the first search, Bluetooth desktop. By the way, does anybody see it? Cool. First thing, Bluetooth desktop locker. In Windows, you have it as a built-in feature. It's called Dynamic Lock. In Mac, you have multiple apps that you can use. Everything you have to pay, of course. And in Linux, we have one project called Blue Proximity. It's in Python, it's open source, but the code there is a little bit problematic. There is a lot of blog post that says that it doesn't work for them, and for me personally, it didn't work. Okay, second Google. Linux Bluetooth destinations, distance sensing. That was easy as well. First thing that I found is this blog post saying that you don't need to be paired. Okay, there is a signal meter, RSSI, okay? It means something like this. If you are more than zero, it means that you are on the chip. If you have zero, it means that you are approximately in your station, okay? And if it's minus three, it's next room, okay? If I'm looking and looking, okay, people talked about that. And one of the guys here write it in Bash, but already writes something that works. Okay, so basically, if we want to check. Okay, it looks something like this. Couple of state parameters. You need for that your MAC address, okay? And this is the loop. Trying to get RSSI. If you succeeded, check if you are connected. If not, trying to connect. If you are not if you are connected, trying to get the RSSI reading, okay? And another little bit of STD out for pretty prints. Cool. For the example, I need my friend here, Ronnie, and let's see how it looks. So here I have my phone. As you can see, we are already connected and we are near. Running is going. You can go. Okay, as you can see, when Ronnie is going, we're getting less and less. Ronnie, you can come back. Woo, Ronnie! Thank you. So this is the script. Cool, works. Next thing. As you saw, when I wrote, ran it, there is a lot of STD out. Some of them are relevant for my script and some of them are not. For that, we will try to work with Poppen, subprocess Poppen. Okay, this is some tricks. We set the STD out as a pipe. And set buffer size to 1 and this parameter. To set the buffer to the STD out as a pipe and buffer size as 1 means that the pipe will have a buffer of 1 line. If it writes 1 line and I'm not reading it, it will block and wait till the next time. I'm starting the process. This is another nice thing. Instead of reading all the lines, okay, I'm creating a new iterable that read line by line, and it will break, get a stop iterator, only when we will get a end of file, when the process is stopped. Removing the spaces and removing the lines that we don't need, and then printing them. Let's see it just for a second. Ronnie. This time, let's do it quickly. Okay, cool. Only the lines that I need to know what is the stat correctly. Now the logic. We are talking about Bluetooth, about connection, about network. There will always be white noise. Because of that, I can't just take the last reading and use it. Sometimes when I'm sitting in my station, I will get some bad readings. So what I did instead of that is use a queue. In this case, a queue of length of 5 is enough. Every time that the SSI reading is less than -1, I'm adding 1 to the queue. Every time that it's more or equal to -1, I take 1 from the queue. If I'm full, I'm locking the desktop. And if I'm locked and less than 3, I will less than 4 values in the queue, I'm sorry, I will unlock the desktop. If you want to see the code, it looks like something like that. A little bit static. This is the sensor script. This is the lines that we don't care about. I'm using Kubuntu Linux. So this is my command to lock to screen save my computer and to unlock it, okay? This is my function. I'm setting here the queue and the current state. I have here 3 helper functions. 1 that parse the line, said if it's relevant or not, and update the queue. 1 to pretty print the state to our STD out. And 1 to check the current state. We are opening the process, getting line by line, parsing, getting the state, and locking or unlocking. And in the end, pretty printing the status. Okay, let's see demo. The queue size is 0, 1, go. go away. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. And when I'm coming from the coffee, it works. Now the code here is not hard. Little bit Google in it and you will find everything. The point here is two things. One, if you have something that you don't like at work, don't hate. Think about ways to learn, to do better things for yourself and for other people. Second thing, please stop hacking one another. That's my personal opinion. The only last thing that I found out from this project is now currently people are not trying to hack me. They are trying when I'm coding to steal my phone. Thank you.